As if it wasn't enough that you could categorize by rows, columns, and filters, in the more recent versions of Excel, you actually have something called slices. So if I click on a pivot table and I go to analyze, you'll see there's an option here to insert a slicer and a timeline. So let's just do the slicer first. When I click insert slicer, this pops up and it mimics all the fields that are shown here. So we're going to choose a few fields. So I'm going to choose some that are already in here. So let's do destination, network, and maybe weekday, weekend. And then I'm going to choose one that's not in here already. So let's go and choose type. When I say OK, you'll see that these three boxes appear. Now, as you can see, you can move them around. What we could do is maybe put them up here. So something like that. The way these things work is if I click on one of these cells, it affects this pivot table. So notice destination network is currently all. Notice destination network, all of them are highlighted. If I click cell C, it's the same as me clicking on this one and switching cell C on. If I do MTN, so it's a little bit easier way to actually change the underlying report. As you can see, destination network is already in here. Weekday, weekend is already in here. If you wanted to show more than one item, by holding your control button down and clicking it, you'll see we've got multiple items. And if we want to go back to all to see everything again, we can just click in the top right here. Now notice that these two are already in here. This type is actually not in here. It's not shown anywhere here. But Excel knows that when you've pulled out this type, you may want to apply this filter as well to these pivot, this pivot report. So for example, if I click SMS, can you see the numbers now change to display all these criteria depending on what's here, but only SMS. Notice as well, which is quite nice, is that when I click SMS, it's hinting at the fact with a slightly different color that SMSs, there is nothing relating to telecom and voicemail. So you cannot actually choose to see the SMSs for telecom because there are none. So that is a bit of useful information, but we could go and, for example, go to MTN. So now we're seeing SMSs only for MTN. And we obviously can go and switch these all on so that we're seeing everything again. As with anything in Excel, there's always a little bit of customization you can do. So for example, if I click on that slicer, you'll notice that there's a new ribbon option. And when I click on it and go to options, you'll see I've got a whole variety of options. So just going through them, let's go from right to left. We can obviously control the size. So if we want, we can reduce the size a bit to fit properly, and we can control the width. You can control the number of columns. So at the moment, we've got one column. But maybe if I put two columns, you'll see they're next to each other, and maybe we can resize it a bit. And if we really needed to, I could make it nice and flat and horizontal. You can see you can play with the alignment. You can do all of these sort of things. If you don't like the color schemes, you know, maybe change it to a color scheme you want, whichever one you want. And then at the end here, you've got a couple of options. You have the ability to control the report connections. And you'll see a few options there. And this is an extremely, extremely useful feature, which we cover in a separate lesson. And then you've got slicer settings. And this is where you can control how the slicer must act. So notice you can give it a name and change the name. You can specify the sort order. So notice here it's going in ascending order, but you can put a descending or create a custom list. This is where you can control whether it should hide items with no data or must it visually grayed out. So there's a whole bunch of settings you can choose here.